show me adventures I haven't seen. Taking all the life, it hits the spot. Hello and welcome everybody to L Viral Reads. Today I'm going to teach you how to write a screenplay. As you can see, this is the first page of my screenplay. It's called Trap, and these are my full names, and it is an animation film. So this also teaches you how to write an animation film, the basics that you need to know of how to write your own screenplay starting today. So please, before we start, like and subscribe down below, share this video to your friends, and make sure you watch it until to the end of this tutorial. And also make sure, please to watch other videos. They are there for your entertainment. So please give me a thumbs up and a like. Thank you so much. Okay, now this is the first page of my script. Every page should be, you have to have the title. Like mine, I've named mine Trap. And the name of the author, your name, you have to write it down here. And the logline, a short one or two brief sentences explaining what the film is totally about, like based on, like this one. As you can see, it is an animation film. It cannot be used to make a drama, an action, or whatever kind of films other than animation. So this one is strictly for animation. So if a production company gets a hold of this script, they'll automatically know definitely this one is meant for animation. So you have the title, your name as the author, a short log line, and then down here onto the left side, all your contact details. You can put in your emails, your phone contacts, and even your Facebook profile name. So it's easier for the production company to get a hold of you wherever you are so easily and produce the movie. So that's it. That is how the first page usually looks like. Don't forget all your contacts onto the left side, and then we have the title and the name of the author. You can leave it, but I prefer it to be there. That's how I write all my films. And then now let's go on to page 2. That's the first, page 2. This is how it looks like. You have the transition shot. Here I've written, you have the scene heading. EXT always means exterior, like outside a building, outside a box. Side, it just means outside something. Then you have the place, like here I've written the sky. After exterior, the next place I've written is the sky, and then time of day. You put midday, evening. That will put a lot of stress, not unless you want to emphasize on it, but what is usually recommended, the movie company will know how to deal with it. They produce or they work with you as the writer. So this is how you write the scene heading, and this is a transition. It can be on either side, on the right like it is right now, or here on the left. It's you, it's your choice. And then now as we proceed down here, it's where we faction lines. This is just a brief explanation of what should be happening within the frame lines of the movie production, which what should strictly be seen. This is how you introduce a character. First time always, when you just use capital letters, never forget that. Capital letters for every time you introduce a new character onto your film. That is a must. Fingertips. And then next, if it's something, a name of a city, a name of an object, it must start with a capital letter, or you can put all of it in caps. As you can see, here is the line log shown, and then I've introduced another character, caps for her old name, Lisa. And if it's time of day or night, you can just, if it's in the act, you can just use normal small caps, capital small caps letters, but so much as long as you paint the picture of what you want to be seen onto the script you are writing. So this is the first page, and this is what we call, the whole of this is what we call a dialogue, and this is the character speaking. So the dialogue comes before, after the character who is speaking. Like here, Arnold speaks and says, "Hey Lisa, comma, that was something, huh? Question mark." So that brief dialogue of what this Arnold character is saying. And as you see down here, we can see brackets, yeah? This is what we call parentheticals. What are parentheticals? They are short, brief action lines that an actor can do while the film is going on. So never forget to do that, but it is recommended to use as little as possible of these parentheticals, for some production companies don't like them, and also it can also make your script look ugly, and people won't even be interested to read your script. But use them as little as possible, like I have, and make sure your punctuation marks, you must put all full stops where they are needed. You must put all commas, all semicolons and colons where they are needed for it to look as professional as possible. So please, please, please keep that in mind. And another thing you have to note, if a scene continues onto the next page, before the next page flipped, the software that you flipped will automatically put this word over here, continued, meaning what? It continues on to the next page, so the scene is not ending on one page, but it ends on the other. When we get on to the next page down here, you can see it for yourself. It puts it on the right side, and then when you go on to the next page, page number 2, it puts it on the left, so as to give direction to the director and the production company. So this scene continues on to the next scenes, your dialogues and your parentheticals, as we've seen here. Like here we have another transition. This is another transition. You can use cut to, you can use smash to, you can choice, but the professional one, it's cut to. That is known like and about. And this is where I've introduced the main title of my the software that I usually use for writing this script is called Celtics. Celtics is very good. It puts your script and organizes it for you to easily write your script. It's stress-free for a writer. I recommend that you download it for free on the www.celtics.com. You'll get it for free and how to use it. But right now, we are focusing on the script. Now we have entered onto another scene here. It is called INT bedroom day. Int for interior, bedroom, time of day, it's day. Daniel, the main character, aged 14. This is how you introduce the age. And you can use other means of introducing age, but to make it simpler, to make it professional, to give you a professional touch, to make sure that the production company you are giving a script to, or your friend, or even just a close mate, will see that you've truly done something with your script and will totally adore it, you have to write it this way. Simple, clean, elegant, with no heavy words, because the people who want to read your script must go through it quickly. We don't want to give them headache. We don't want them to have a hard time reading, going through, perusing through pages. So we write scripts as easily as possible. So this is the another transaction. The title, this is how you can introduce a title that is based in a film before it starts. Now, after an introduction, as you've seen, I've done with this script. And this is the character name, don't forget that. And this is the dialogue that they are speaking out, like, "Damn, how could I be so blind not to see it?" And don't forget, very, very important, the punctuation marks. And also don't forget, every time you introduce a character, you use capital letters. Always keep that in mind. Never, ever, ever forget that. And also, if you want to, if you want a certain character to do something or to move something, you use these parentheticals. Like here, Negan Bird is talking to Fessy, so the director or the production company will know how what to do or how to do it, so as Negan to face Fessy and talk the dialogue that is down here. Simple, easy. So something else to note is a script be between 80 to 120 pages. If your script doesn't serve those pages, please continue writing until you reach those limits, because that is the total number of pages a company, a production company, will accept for a feature screenplay, not a short film, but a feature screenplay. So if you want them to take you seriously, more pages count. Please add some more if you haven't, and if you have, congratulations, you are on your way to production now. All you have to do is get in contact with a production studio and get the film started. Don't worry, I know you'll do it. If you have already written a script, I know the rest is just a walk in the park. So please don't forget, the page limits are 80 to 120. If you have those page limits, congratulations for you. You are awesome and you are fantastic, because it's not easy to write a screenplay and complete it. Yeah, I know the struggles. I myself have written about 20 screenplays and they have been a headache, and I'm still writing. And it's so tough making it out there as a writer of a screenplay, but this simple video will guide you step by step on how to write a professional one. So also keep in mind all that I've taught you in this video. Please don't forget them, because they are the beacons, they are the foundation of how you will make it in the film industry as an actor of your own film. You can write it and also get in contact with a company, they will produce it for you. It's your agreement that you make with them. The agreement that you make with them will determine whether you'll be the director or the producer, or just remain the writer. There, it's your choice. But please stick to the protocols that I've taught you in this video. They will really, really help you. And also, if you have any other questions, you can ask them. Any questions regarding screenplay, I'll answer you, and I'll keep on posting videos just for you. And we'll be on this journey for quite a long time, because I want you to get what is really needed to know on how to write a screenplay. Also to note, I'm also looking for a production company. This script called Trap is already complete. I've written 90 pages of it. And it's so awesome. I've given it to a few friends of mine, a few editors, a few grammar, a few lecturers, and they've told me it's awesome. And they've told me, they've encouraged me to make it. And reaching out to you if you're a producer, if you're a director, if you can, please let's hold hands. You can reach me on these contacts over here. This is my Facebook name, Elvis Captain Pin. Just inbox me as I've written. You can text me through these numbers or call me. You can email me also. Any means that you choose of contacting me, I'll be there to answer. I'll be waiting for you. And I want us to make this movie, which I know will be a lot of success, because I'm really determined to make this film along with other films that I've written. Remember, writing doesn't stop, production doesn't stop, entertainment is always dust for everyone on this earth. So please, if you're a producer, if you're a director, get in contact with me, let's make this script. Or if you want me to sell it to you, just get in contact with me and we'll do the deal as privately as possible, or we can produce them and showcase the world what we've got. And that will be really cool, because I'll teach also other people how to become an animation director if given the chance of producing this script because people need to know this stuff, but they don't know where to start. They are confused. Some are getting conned and all that. So please, if a production company reaches out to me, if you are one of them, a director, producer, please, please, please get in contact. It will turn out to be a great success. Thank you so much for watching. Please watch out for the other video as I teach you how to use the Celtics screening software. Thank you so much for watching. Share this video. Subscribe to my channel. There are lots to learn about scripting that is not told. I'll teach you all the secrets. Thank you so much. See you all in the next video. Please watch out for other videos and please watch other videos that I've posted in my channel for your entertainment. Thank you so much. That's made up, baby, that's made up.